Good morning, everybody. I hope you've all had a great March break. I want to show you something this morning. This is something we all have in our homes, isn't it? It's a light bulb. And if it's something very common, we don't even give them much thought anymore. But you can see it's made of very thin glass. And inside, you can see that very thin wire, and that's called the filament. And that's the part that lights up when you run the electricity through. That's the part that helps create the glow. And as I say, we don't think very much about these anymore. When you need them, you pick them up at the hardware store or the grocery store. You put them in, you get rid of the old ones, and carry on. This wasn't always the case. When light bulbs were first being developed, they were very hard to make and very, very delicate. And there's a wonderful story I want to share with you. Thomas Edison was one of the people who did a lot of work on creating the light bulb and how to develop that and bring electric light into people's homes. And when he was making electric light bulbs, they took a very long time. It would take 24 hours to make one light bulb. So you can imagine how hard everybody would work and how carefully they would treat these. So one day, Thomas Edison and his team had made, finally, a light bulb that worked. 24 hours of work to make one light bulb. And it had to go be put away upstairs. And they gave it to a young boy who was helping and asked him to carry it up the stairs and put it away. So very carefully, he climbed the stairs one at a time, very, very carefully. And then at the top, he tripped and dropped the light bulb and it broke. And they had to start all over again. 24 more hours, make another light bulb, and then it has to go away. So they gave the light bulb, the new light bulb they made, to the same young man, and he carried it very carefully up the stairs. This time, it worked. He made it to the top, didn't trip, light bulb was intact. And some people said, why would you take the chance and give this light bulb to the same person who broke the first one? And they said, you know, stuff happens. Mistakes happen. Everybody deserves a second chance. And that's what our Bible story is about today. In the Gospel of Luke, chapter 13, there's a story about a fig tree. And this man owns a fig tree, and he is very frustrated because this fig tree is not producing any fruit. It's a very nice fig tree, lots of leaves, but no fruit. And this is the whole point to having a fig tree, is to grow figs. And so he decides it should be cut down. And so he went to the vineyard and he told his gardener, take down this tree. For years, it's been supposed to produce figs. It's producing nothing. And the gardener said, no, sir, let me try again. We'll dig around it. We'll put some fertilizer in and we'll see if we can make it work. Please don't cut it down yet. And so the owner of the vineyard said, okay, we'll give it one more year. Now, just like the trees in the vineyard, we are supposed to produce good fruit too, right? We are God's children and God wants us to produce good fruit like love and kindness and patience and peace and joy and all those good things. And if we think of Jesus as the gardener, just as the gardener in the vineyard worked the soil around the tree and gave it the fertilizer and nourishment that it needed, Jesus does that for us. And when we let Jesus into work in our lives, when we listen to what Jesus teaches, when we try to live as Jesus taught us, then that's letting Jesus work in our lives so that we can produce that good fruit in God's world. And that's a wonderful thing, isn't it? Because there will be times we don't produce good fruit. There will be times that we are angry and maybe hurt someone else's feelings or do things we're not supposed to do, all of those things. But God always keeps working in our lives. And God always keeps giving us second chances. That's a wonderful thing. So keep that in mind as you go back to school this week. Think about all of the good fruit that you can produce and work hard to do that and see if you can help others do the same thing. Take good care, everyone. Wash your hands, wear your masks. God bless. Bye, folks.